it's Hannah, and welcome back to my channel, or hi, hello, if you're new here. If you're new here, hi, hello, and welcome. It is a great video for you to see from me, if this is going to be your very first time watching me, because I'm going to be talking to you all today about what makeup means to me. So, I have been really into commentary videos recently. I'm not going to start doing them here on my channel, just because I don't have the guts to, like, say stuff about certain influencers and YouTubers. I don't have the guts to call them out. But, hey, props to the ones that do, okay? But I don't have the guts to do that, so I'm not gonna do it myself. But this is technically kind of a commentary video because I'm telling you what something means to me. You don't have to sit here and physically, like, watch me. You can turn me on and just have me in the background when you're doing something. So, that's really what I like to use these commentary videos for. So, go ahead and get out your listening ears and let's go ahead and get into this video. So, makeup to me is about art and just self-expression. Makeup is the one thing that I can do for myself independently, 100% on my own. And I have to have help with most daily tasks, which is fine. I'm very thankful for help. But, you know, there's nothing wrong with having help. Everybody needs help every now and again or on a daily basis. But for me, it's nice to just have something that I can do for myself 100% on my own. And I am very thankful that I don't have issues with opening certain packaging or anything like that, so that I can independently pretty much always open my own packaging. Skincare can be a little hard and a little tricky, but for the most part for me, I can pretty much always do all the own packaging opening myself and apply the products, and it's just really nice to have something for myself that I can do by myself. So I guess what I was trying to say in a roundabout way, makeup gives me a self of independence, and it is something that I can do independently on my own, and it gives me independence. Makeup, in a sense, also gives me a form of expression, because I have to be very picky. Well, not picky. I pretty much wear children's size clothing. I can't wear anything adult-sized, and that limits what I can actually wear, because it's very hard finding clothes in the kids department, which is why I don't clothes shop hardly ever, because it's very hard to find things that look age appropriate. You know, most little kids, they want to wear things that's got Frozen on them, or JoJo, or whatever other little cartoon, whatever kids are into. I don't know what kids are into today. You know, I'm just using some examples here of, like, things that I'll find. And it's so hard, because I don't want to go out in public with that stuff. I don't watch any of that, those things or anything like that. So it's just very hard for me to clothes shop. And makeup is something that everyone can wear, no matter what. Everyone can express themselves with it and just have fun with it. It brings everyone together, which is awesome. I love that. During the makeup community, I have made a ton of friends, and I'm very happy to say that, and I have. For me, makeup is just self-expression because I'm not limited to what I can wear. You know, when a new eyeshadow palette comes out, I automatically know I can wear it because makeup fits everyone and it's in everyone's size range. So, I'm not limited when it comes to makeup. I can, you know, experiment. Well, as long as it doesn't have certain ingredients in the foundations. I have to watch foundations, but other than that, I get to express myself with makeup and I don't have to worry about, you know, it not fitting me or it not being age appropriate, because anybody can express themselves with makeup. It doesn't matter your age, your gender, your race, whatever. Everybody can have fun with it. So that's why another reason why I like makeup too is it's just a form of self-expression. Makeup is also a huge way for me to practice self-care. There's several different types of self-care, and when you struggle really badly, like I do with anxiety, you know, it's nice to have something to help you with that, and to also help you not focus on what's making you anxious or what's upkicking your anxiety. Going back into the self-care thing, you know, self-care, so many people label it so many different things and consider so many different things self-care, and they get into arguments about what's actually self-care. Listen, self-care, I will tell you, it is a multitude of things for a multitude of different people. Making your bed every day is a form of self-care. Doing a chore or a task that you've been putting off for a long time, that's also a form of self-care. So you feel really good about yourself after you've completed something. Whether that be putting your laundry away or doing something in your yard that you've been meaning to do. Self-care is, you could be baking. I don't know. I know people that like to bake that have anxiety. It makes them feel better about themselves, but just gives them something to do and to focus on. And for me, makeup is a form of self-care because I tune everything out around me. I focus just strictly on my makeup in that moment. I don't even lay out clothes the night before the next day. You know, some people lay out their outfits. I don't do that. I always lay out palettes that I want to use, and it helps with my anxiety to have products that I'm excited to use and new product launches that I'm excited about. It just helps me in so many different ways and just calms me and just soothes me. You know, I always lay out my palettes and I get really excited about the next day to get up and to use the palette that I picked out to use that day. I always have a new palette, or not a new palette, but I always have a palette sitting on my desk ready for me to start my next day with and to get creative with. So, to me, it's also a form of self-care. I guess, in a sense, you know, makeup can mean so many different things to so many different people. But to me, it's given me independence. You know, it's something, like I said, I can do 100% on my own. It's something that helps me with my anxiety and gives me something to look forward to. It's something that I don't feel limited with and can express myself and wear everything out there possible to wear, because with clothes, I'm so, so limited. So I love the fact that I can focus and get to wear things that I want to wear on my face that I want to wear because I'm not limited in that department. So I guess to me, makeup is a bunch of different things, and that's what makeup means to me. It gives me independence, it helps me express myself further, and it just helps me overall with my anxiety and gets me excited about the new day and the new day ahead. So I just really love makeup for that purpose. I don't do makeup because I feel like I'm ugly and that I need makeup, or that I need makeup to be beautiful. That's not what that is to me. To me, it's about expressing myself and having fun and just boosting my confidence and just, you know, and there's a difference between boosting your confidence and feeling like you're ugly. There are some people out there that they do makeup because they do feel like they need it, which is awful. You should never, ever go into that mentality when you're starting out with makeup. But yeah, I just wanted to share this video with you all today and just talk to you all about it. I do have an announcement, though, before I leave y'all with this video. I have just started a TikTok exclusively for my makeup content. I feel really weird posting my makeup content on my current TikTok, or my TikTok that I have. I just feel really weird about it. I don't know, honestly. I'll probably never will stop posting on my old one. I don't know. I just feel so weird putting makeup content on there. I just feel so strange because I started out that TikTok doing like funny little videos and like put a finger down challenge. I was so obsessed with those. So to me, it just was so strange, like having makeup content just sporadically thrown in there. And I have a bunch of different makeup things that I want to do on TikTok that I didn't want to overload that TikTok particularly. So I just like, you know what? I'm going to make another TikTok, and I'm just going to have two TikToks, and I'm just going to also have a TikTok where I do makeup on. And who knows? Maybe that'll be the one that I end up focusing on. I don't know. It's a lot easier to get my makeup content out there on TikTok because it's not so saturated. And then a roundabout way, I've been on TikTok that I know the roundabout ways to get your stuff out there. Not that that's important, but I do have goals. I want to be on the ColourPop PR list. So, that's my goal. I want to be on the ColourPop PR list. So, yeah, that's my goal. This is what I'm working on. This is what I'm currently got my mindset on, is I want to be on the ColourPop PR list. I'm going to get there. I don't know when, I don't know how, but I'm going to get there. I'm going to do it. So, yeah, I really hope that you all did enjoy this video. Thank you all so much for watching this. I greatly appreciate it. Do two things for me before you leave. Number one, give me a big thumbs up down below. And also, don't forget to give me a subscribe while you're down there as well. I want to reach 15,000 subscribers by the summertime. And you can also give me a follow over on my social media handles as well, as it is a great way to keep up with me and keep tabs on me. So, yeah, I will see you all in Thursday's video. Bye, my little unicorns.